Hi, Founder fans. Jason here. Today's founder is Tench Tilghman, a young man from Maryland who served as an aide-de-camp to General George Washington during the Revolutionary War. Now, Tench Tilghman comes from a Maryland family, as I noted. They were a merchant family and very successful. But when the Revolutionary War is coming around, and I like to reiterate this all the time, the Revolutionary War was a civil war. And the Tilghman family is a great example of this, because once war breaks out, Tench's father and two brothers become loyalists. And Tilghman becomes a patriot, and this affects the family relationship for the next several decades, for really the remainder of his life. Now, Tench did have an uncle, Matthew Tilghman, who was a leading patriot. He was the chairman of the provincial assembly in that colony and a delegate to the First Continental Congress, so he was not alone in this endeavor, but Tilghman decides to join the fight. He first joins the Maryland militia, but is quickly assumed into the Continental Army, where he is recognized as an asset and taken under the wings of General George Washington, who appoints Tilghman as a military secretary and aide-de-camp. Tilghman works with another military secretary, Robert Hanson Harrison. Most of the people who joined what Washington called his family were younger men, late teens, early 20s. Tilghman and Harrison were a little bit older. Tilghman was 31 when he joins up, but therefore is a little bit higher ranked than many of these young men might otherwise have been. He also is fluent in French, which is highly significant for George Washington, especially once the French join the fight. He takes dictation from Washington and translates it and sends it over to the French to correspond with them. Additionally, when Baron von Steuben shows up and starts reorganizing this not very great Continental Army into an actual army, Tench Tilghman is right there with him, helping to translate through the different languages, through the Prussian to the French to English. He also joins the fight through most of the war, and is present for the victory at Yorktown. And it's while he's at Yorktown that the victory is won and the British army is captured. And General Washington appoints Tilghman with the privilege of getting on horseback and riding to Philadelphia to inform the Continental Congress that the Revolutionary War had been won and the British army captured. It is the midnight ride of Tench Tilghman, if you will. It's one of the most significant rides of the war. Now, unfortunately, Tilghman had been falling ill for years at this point and was even very sick with a fever and chills on his famous ride, or not as famous as it should be, ride to Philadelphia that night. He would return to private life. He would work trading mostly with Spain as a merchant in his ensuing years, but the illness catches up with him, and sadly, he passes away at just 41 years old in 1786, before the Constitution is even written. He most assuredly would have been a part of the federal government with the respect Washington had for him, and you see some of the letters Washington wrote after Tilghman passes away, indicating the real respect he had for this man. So Tilghman more than likely would have been a member of the federal government in some capacity. I also want to note that the name Tench is an amazing name. He's not the only Tench in the American Revolution that I've come across. Unfortunately, my spouse would not let me name my children Tench, but I still think it's a fantastic name. I hope you learned a little bit about Tench Tilghman today and how much fun his name is. If you did, hit like. If you're new here, subscribe. I put out videos about the American Revolution all week long, and I'll be back with another founder for you tomorrow.